Hi, Marcus Reynolds here, the embouchure guy. Stratusbrass.com, the creator of the Stratus embouchure system. Today, I want to talk about playing down the slide. Now, my group, Brass Embouchure Advice on Facebook, is, and several other groups are talking about tuning slide in or tuning slide out. Well, I like the tuning slide in, closed. And the reason for that is I like to play down the slide. I just feel some of the notes need that bit more adjustment than others. And if you're at home, if you're on the stocks, as it were, if you're here, there's nowhere to go. Whereas if you play down the slide, you've got some options. And I hear you say, but surely it's going to change the tuning. Well, yes, it does. But you tune to it. So, for example, if you play your B flat, and then you play it in fifth, but if I play it here, one, the instrument doesn't seem to respond to it very well. And every instrument's different. This is a Rath R12. I very proudly was invited to redesign this, co-design it with Michael Rath. And I'm also one of his artists, which I'm very proud to say. But back to the B flat. So if I play down the slide, and what I generally do is, it's not a full thumb width, but it's a little way down. If you can see, it's sort of here. Let me. Yeah, look. It's quite a way away, look. Just on that ridge there. And then work up. And then the D is on a little bit on the flat side. So you've got room to bring it into the first position, just that little bit further in. So, now, you heard that was sharp. Takes a little bit of work, but it is worth it. And then I can, if I have a B flat, in a solo, there's much more room. It does take a bit of getting used to, but what I do find that the less tubing you've got to play in, the instrument becomes more alive. And it'll be different for everybody. The late Bill Watrous, recently late Bill Watrous, he had some cut off his tuning slide. Well, I haven't gone as far as that, but several instrumentalists have. And also, some instruments I see on the social medias, they say that you've got to have the tuning slide out or in. Well, I don't know about that. Every instrument's slightly different. And all the players were all slightly different. I remember my professor at the Royal Military School of Music, Nella Hall, which has spawned thousands of great musicians. And I would just like to say that The first day I was introduced to alternative positions by my professor, I didn't like it at all. I didn't like effing. But because he didn't explain probably clearly enough to me, I was only a young guy, probably I didn't understand that I was probably playing this too far up. He didn't cover that. So now, apart from a few cycles, that's nearly the same tuning. And the beauty of it is that if I play my F and G in fourth, it's got a lot more bounce and a lot more ceiling room than... It's fighting there a little bit. It's the short second, as you know, the G. And then I play the A in fourth when I'm doing certain solos. Play around with it. Don't forget, this is my mantra as well. Now, for the first time, for a long time, we've got time to listen to ourselves. And I was doing that a few months ago. I've been doing some home recording for Jazz Colossus in Northampton and a couple of other outfits. And I didn't like my tone. I wanted to improve my tone. So I've been working a lot on little tunes and little ballads. And that's turned into a vanity project. And the vanity project, because of the musicians on it, have said, well, let's do an album. So I'm now working on a complete album. And I want to get this sort of smooth... That was all third and fourth. A lot smoother instead of having a... I suppose if I doodle tongue out and get that smooth. It'll take a little while. Don't use a tuner. Use your ears. Start off with really something simple, like F to F, first to six. Then the B flat. Then play it down a slide even more. You'll feel you've got a lip too much there. There's a tiny bit of up lipping, but not enough. Have a play around with it. Don't be frightened. You won't get it right to start with. So it was a bit flat, that. In the context of a piece of music you're playing, you'll automatically go to that fourth position, or that long fourth position. You'll automatically go to it. You will. The tuning is different. But what I do find is, in the alternative positions, E in fifth is lovely as well. But I'm getting off the track, playing down the slide we were talking about. So work on your... your B flat and your F. And just pull it down. And you'll very quickly adjust. So that means if I want to put vibrato there, I find it helps with my ballad playing a lot. So you don't have to play down the slide. Many players play in the first position. I just find it's a bit clunky. Also, you can also bang the stocks. And that's not very pleasant either. So I hope that's give some indication of what playing down the slide is. My name's Marcus Reynolds, strutusbrass.com. I'm the creator of the Strutus embouchure system. I've written a book called Range Without Resistance with a short video course that goes with it in videos. And any questions you've got, just go to Brass Embouchure Advice. And I'll leave a couple of links on the YouTube panel. If you've enjoyed this and you like this close-up, very detailed, very honest approach to some of the tips, they're more than tips, really. They're my lifetime study of 45 years, probably even longer. Let's not add that up. I'm glad I'm not a very good mathematician, no. But you'll find that there's several things that aren't talked about by other teachers. And you'll also find that some of these things are not written in the books. But my potted history is I learned to play again after being a professional. I fell off stage, trombone went through here, end of career, and I've learned to play again. And it's been a horrendous journey. So if you want to know more about that, want to know more about me, please subscribe and have a listen to my ballads where you'll see me and hear me playing some of the alternative shift positions as well as down the slide. On Marcus Reynolds Trombone on YouTube. So, see you all again soon. Brass Embouchure Advice is the group. If you want to come on there and say hello and share with me some of your playing experiences, that'd be great. Marcus Reynolds, stratosbrass.com. I look forward to seeing you at some point. Please subscribe. And I'll keep these little training tips and videos going. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye.